near the modeling. Concept developed by Dr. Peter Chen in 1976. Here you would understand the entity relationship and you make a diagram over there. And you know what is DFD and what is ERD. So in first part, we have discussed about this. And entity, and then relationships, attributes, all of them so far we discussed. So we can just ignore them. This bookshop, so you have gone through that, right? So we have to identify entities. Of them we have so far discussed, right? What we do is we're going to understand. So we understood what is a key and what is a candidate key and what is a composite key and what is a primary key and what is alternate key. All of them we discussed. Okay. Now you know. Okay. Single attribute key, multiple attribute keys, candidate keys, primary keys, alternate keys. Now foreign keys I did not explain, so I'm going to explain foreign keys now. So before understanding foreign keys, let us understand what is an entity. Okay, the step number 5 or 6, I don't know what is the step number, but I'm right. So step number 5. Okay, so identify between entities. Okay, so arity means, you know what is arity? Arity means degree of association. In mathematics, you would have studied 1-to-1, studied 1-to-m, then you would have studied m-to-m, many-to-many. Okay, so these three are called arity or degree of association. How two entities are related, how two entities are, you know, sharing the relationship. So let us understand now. One bookshop can have many branches and each branch belongs to only that bookshop. So in this you have maximum is 1. From here the maximum is m. So it is complete 1-to-m relationship. So one author can write many books and one book can be written by many authors. Okay, so in this the maximum is many and here also the maximum is m. So this is author and books is completely many to many relationship. Okay, one branch can store multiple books and one kind of book can be stored in multiple branches. So this is m is to m. Like that, one publisher can publish many books and one kind of book can be published by only the publisher. This is 1-to-m. Okay, so if you take in this case study, you have 1-to-m and many to many, but unfortunately we did not get 1-to-1. Okay, but you may have 1-to-1, 1-to-m, m-to-m. So let us understand, you know, how we can use this concept in our diagrams. Okay, so can you give me some example for 1-to-1? So forget about our case study. In real life, do you have any entities where you have 1-to-1 relationship? Can you give me some one? Okay. So let me take. I have two entities. The customer. Other one is called movie tickets. Any movie tickets you buy, each customer will get only one ticket and one ticket will be given to only one customer. So this is pure 1-to-1. You may buy 2 tickets or 10 tickets, but not for you, right? It is for your friend or your brother. So each customer will have only one ticket for one customer. So this is a pure 1-to-1. So let me take customer. One customer will get one ticket. Now ticket is issued to one customer. Okay, so this is pure 1-to-1 relationship. 1-to-1 relationship. T ठीक है. नाउ लेट मी आइडेंटिफाई द एट्रीब्यूट्स. कस्टमर आईडी, नेम ऑफ द कस्टमर, देन एड्रेस, देन सेल फोन नंबर, जेंडर एंड अदर डिटेल्स. ओके, व्हाट इज द प्राइमरी की इन दिस? द प्राइमरी की वुड बी दिस. दिस इज द प्राइमरी की. ओके, लेट अस अंडरस्टैंड. हियर टिकट नंबर and screen number, have date, price of the ticket and the other details. So here the primary key is, okay, now I have two entities. I have 1:1 relationship. I have some attributes. I have some primary keys. Now you think that you are developing a small app for a movie theater. Now when you book a ticket, now Kavya goes and she is ordering for the ticket. So customer ID say 1, Kavya is going and she is giving some address and some cell phone number and some gender information. She booked a ticket. Now what is the ticket she got? It she got a ticket number, say 1234, and show time some blah blah blah, screen number say 2, and date some date, and price is say 200 rupees. Okay, now she got this ticket. Now the second customer, who's the second customer, say 2, say Funny goes, and some details you can have and like this. And here the ticket number for the Funny is, say this is the ticket number. Now screen number say 1. So the ticket cost is again 200 rupees. Like that, people are going and booking the tickets, and they're collecting the data of the customer. They're collecting the data of the ticket. Okay, now show is went through and everything is gone. Now after a 2 days time, 3 days time, somebody is asking, what is the, you know, Funny's ticket number? Or 3459, this ticket will be issued to one customer, but who's the customer? Now I don't have any clue who is the customer for ticket number 1234 and 3459, or I don't have any clue what is the ticket number for Kavya. Why? Because I never mentioned anywhere. Okay, so when we have a one-to-one relationship, what is that we have to do is, we have to repeat this primary key. Now I have a primary key here. Now take the CID here, and you have to keep CID also here. Okay, now when you say CID, now you have to write the number here. What is the number for CID? Now 1234 is given to Kavya. What is Kavya's number? 1. What is the, you know, ticket number for 3459? The Funny's number. Funny's number is 2. Like that, you have to keep attribute, and this is the primary key here. Primary key here. So now what you have done is, we have taken this primary key value, we have just kept it here, and this is now known as a foreign key. This is now known as a foreign key. What is the relation? What is the, you know, use of a foreign key? You know, by seeing the foreign key, you would understand it will maintain a relationship between this and this. Okay, now you would see here and here we have relationship. Now whatever be the number you would be repeating in the foreign key. So tomorrow a customer can easily identify this ticket number is given to this guy, and this, you know, this ticket number is given to this guy by using this. Why it is known as a foreign key? This key, it is available in this table. If you are in this country, you are a local. And when you leave this country and go to some other country, you will become a foreigner. Like that, CA is available here. This is a local key or primary key. When it is coming here and sitting in other entity, so it will become a foreign key. Okay, like that. You have to understand the what is the purpose of a foreign key. Foreign key will establish a link, which customer has taken which ticket number. Okay, you can also take a ticket number here and become a foreign key here. So ticket number also can become a foreign key in a draw the diagram. So this is also a ticket number foreign key. Now what is the ticket number for funny? Now that you have written, the ticket number for funny is 1 2 3 4. This is for 3 4 5 9. So that means tomorrow either you can come to, you know, funny's data and identify the ticket number, or you can go to the ticket data, then you can identify the customer number. Okay, actually one foreign key is enough, but you know, if you have one foreign key, you can easily identify who is the customer or who is it, what is the ticket number easily. But Oracle and SQL Server people are recommending two foreign keys, but actually one is sufficient. But people are putting two foreign keys. When you have 1 to 1 primary key, or when you have 1 to 1 relationship, so what is the learning points here? The learning points are two entities are there. Now two primary keys, now you have two foreign keys. Okay, this is the moral of the story. When you have 1 to 1 primary key, 1 to 1 relationship, the primary key of each entity would become a foreign key in the another entity. So what is the rule? So the primary key, the primary key of one entity is foreign key of another entity. This is the rule you have to understand. Actually one is sufficient, but you can keep both so that you can go to any entity you can identify. If you go to customer table, a customer entity, you can easily identify what is the ticket number, or if you go to ticket entity, you can identify who is the customer. So this is the 1:1 relationship. Clear? Any questions? 1:1. So let us identify, let us understand what is 1:m. So let me take a new one. Give you an example. I have a two entities. So one entity is department, and I have employee. Okay. So I have one employee can work for many departments, and one department can have many employees. One employee can work for only one department. So this is a situation make up. Okay, so what is the maximum here? The maximum one. So the maximum will be one here. Okay, so what is the maximum here? M and one. What is the maximum? The M. So here pure 1:m relationship, these two. Okay, so identify the department ID is the primary key, then department name, then HOD department head. So this is the primary key here. Employee number, then name, then salary. That's it. So we can have data about all of them, but as of now we'll stop it here. So employee number is a primary key. Rule here is, here also you have to create a foreign key. Okay, now wherever you have one, the one is available at the department side, so the department will be, you know, because one parent will have many children, now this would become a child. What is child now? Employee. Because one parent will have many children, wherever you have one, so where you have one, department side you have one, and the M is available at which side? The M is available at the employee side. So this is known as a parent entity, and this is known as a child entity. Okay. So this is parent. This is a child entity, where only in 1:m you will get these namings. Okay.
wherever you have one, that's where parent. Wherever you have many, that's where you have children, many. Okay.
Now the parent entity primary key would become a foreign key. Here, this would come here, and that would become a foreign key. That means what? A department ID would become a foreign key here. Ulta. Why we cannot do it ulta? That's slowly you're going to understand. So tomorrow I'll show you why we cannot, you know, keep it employee number as a department employee number as a foreign key. So why we cannot show, I'll discuss with you tomorrow. Okay, but as of now we have to understand, when you have 1:M, the parent entity primary key would become a foreign key in the child entity. Now here, let us understand. 1-to-many relationships, two entities, we have two primary keys, but we have only one foreign key. The foreign key is two. So parent entity PK is FK in, so this is the rule. Okay, parent entity primary key is FK in the child entity. You cannot have two here. You have to have only one. So clear. So this is 1:M. Yeah. A. Is there any doubt or clarification? You can ask me. Primary key, foreign key is clearly, the foreign key is used, you know, to maintain a relationship. What is the ticket number for Funny? And what is the department ID for Funny? Or what is the department ID for Bhaskar? What is the department ID for Kavya? Like that, you can have a department ID is a foreign key. Okay. Now department ID one, department name sales. Say HOD is some Raghu. Department ID two, say marketing. So HOD is say Sunita. Like that, you can have data there. Okay. So this is 1:M. So let us understand the final one. Very important one is 1:many-to-many. Okay. Two entities. So let us take a doctor and let me take a hospital. Now, one doctor, many hospitals. Now, one hospital can have many doctors. Okay. Now this is a pure MSTN and many-to-many relationship. One doctor can work for many hospitals. One hospital can have many doctors. So let us understand doctor ID, the doctor name, then doctor address, say cell phone number. So specialization, speciality. Have some data for joining, salary, all of them. Okay, these will have issues. What are the issues now? Joining also. So question mark. Now why question mark, I'll tell you. So here hospital number, name, address, then say phone number. Okay, let us understand few problems with this. So let me take an Excel sheet and tell you. I have a hospital. Hospital will have hospital number, then name of the hospital, then say some address. Number one, say Apollo. Okay, some address. So may here. Some BBB. Three, Yashoda. Some addresses. So I have some data about hospitals. We'll have this data. Okay, now let me take a doctor. Doctor ID, name of the doctor, then say address, so cell number. Now salary. Now doctor ID 1, say Dr. Bhaskar. Some cell phone number, okay. Now, what is the salary for the Bhaskar is the question mark. Why is the question mark? Because he is working for Apollo morning. Morning hours he will be available in Apollo. Evening hours he will be available in Care Hospital. Apollo is paying 2 lakhs per annum per month and Care is paying 5 lakhs per month. Now, what is the salary you write for him? Do you put 2 lakhs here or 5 lakhs here? So there is a question mark, because one doctor can work for many hospitals and one hospital can have many doctors. Now, Bhaskar is working for, you know, this one, and where, what is it, joining, date of joining in Apollo? 2010, May 1st, I have joined in Apollo. I have joined in Yashoda 2011, October. So what is the date of joining I have to write here? So now these two columns will have an issues, because I don't know what is that I'm going to put here. Now salary, which salary I have to put? Bhaskar, I'm the doctor, I'm working for Apollo in the morning, so I'm getting 2 lakhs. But should I enter 2 lakhs here? Or I'm working for Care also, I'm getting 5 lakhs. So should I enter 5 lakhs there? Or should I enter 2 plus 5, 7 lakhs there? There is a dilemma, there is a question mark, okay? Why you get these kind of issues? Because these two under MSTM, many to many. So when you have many to many, you will have these kind of common attributes. Those need to be deleted from the original table. Delete this. So here also I have to delete. So separately you have to say doctor ID, then hospital number and the salary and date of joining. Now this would become another, what is the salary entity. Okay, now here doctor ID is 1, hospital number is 1, salary 2 lakhs, date of joining October 10th. Okay, now let us take doctor 2, Dr. Kavya. Okay, some cell phone number. Depart doctor number 2, and she is also working for 1, hospital number 1, 5 lakhs. Okay, some date. Doctor ID 1, who is 1? 1 is Bhaskar. Bhaskar is working for, you know, hospital number 3. You know, for here, say 2 lakhs or, you know, 2.7 lakhs or say 3 lakhs package or 4 lakhs, whatever it is. Then date of joining something else. Now, we have to take those common attributes, and those common attributes, you know, should be kept in a separate entity. Now, if you go to our diagram, the date of joining and not be here, I'm cutting it. So here, and we have to take this primary key. Which is the primary key here? Doctor, this is the primary key, come, should come here, and this is also would come here. Okay, now we have to mention ID as a foreign key and hospital number is a foreign key. But this would be in another entity. So this is entire stuff is in another entity. Now you will have three entities when you have MSTM. Okay, so the salary, date of joining, date of relieving, all of them will be separate, will be having you know, each doctor will have 2 salaries, 3 salaries, 5 salaries, and each doctor will have date of joinings. There are 4 to 5 date of joinings, depends upon the hospitals. So you cannot keep a single salary So you have to keep all of them in in a separate entity so that the data will be filled like this. So this is one entity and this is another entity and this is another entity. So you will have three entities here. Okay. Now here in a many to many, you will have entities. Okay. Two primary keys and clear. So you have to be very clear. Many people would ask, why is that you have to go in for one more entity in MSTN? You have to say very clearly, when we have MSTM, we'll have some common attributes like date of joining, date of relieving, salary. The salary is dependent on the hospital and salary is dependent on the doctor. So you have to keep them separate in this third entity. Okay. So this is what MS2M. Now the last thing is that mapping ERD tool mapping. Okay. So serial number and we have ERD, then we have tool. Tool means a SQL Server Oracle serial number one. ERD will say entity. Tool will say table. ERD will say entity instance. Okay. Tool will say a row. Okay, here you would say a attribute. Okay, here you would say a column. Say primary key. Here also primary key. Here you say alternate key, AK. Here you say unique key. Okay, here you say foreign key. There also should say foreign. So end of the day, you would have all entities will become tables, all entity instances will become rows, attributes will become columns, primary key will become a primary key, alternate key will become alternate unique key, foreign key will become a foreign key. Okay, tool means what? SQL Server, Oracle, all these are tools. Okay, so you take the diagram, you have to create all the tables using your commands. Okay. So this is the end of the ERD model. So ERD modeling will clearly tell you the number of tables, primary keys, foreign keys, alternate keys, attributes. So everything you can neatly capture. Okay. So ERD modeling will tell you what is the data you have to capture from a business. If you don't have the ERD, clear ERD, it is very, very difficult for you to understand the data. Clear? So if you have any questions, you can speak now. You can the mic. Clear? Any questions you have?